There we go. What is up, everyone? It is me, Psycho Blue, conductor of the Hype Train, Mr. Hype Gems, hashtag Street Fighter Cross Tekken. This time we have all the volumes set up, so we have a proper Street Chatter Cross Talkin' Volume 2. I have hooked up my Xbox 360 to my desktop. That way we can watch Xbox matches rather than the PC matches that seem to be stuck in the same loop over and over again. I expect a lot more variety on Xbox Live, being this was the main system when the game was most active. That being said, I'm going to open up the Discord chat and see who comes in with us. Hope everyone's enjoying their nice Sunday afternoon. It's been kind of nutty at work, lots of pressure going on for me trying to grow an apartment, but things will come in time. It's just a matter of getting the grind all nice and neat. So let me go into the Discord, open up the chat, and I'll let everyone know we're open for business. And we'll see who comes in. Okay, so I was going through this last night, and I wanted to do through the character channel like I did last time during the test run, I should say, but I didn't see anything that good last night. But so what I'm going to do is go through the Elite channel and see what we got there, and then we'll pick another date to have an official character breakdown. I invited HD Jammers earlier, but didn't have any Christy or Poison matches. I was hoping I'd have someone to feature Christy, so I might hit up The Last Dragon, a.k.a. Zykes, to see if that'll work. But for now, we'll just watch some more Elite matches and see who we got. Let's go to the replay channel. Alright, let's begin our stroll through memory lane. I wasn't very active on Xbox, so don't see much of me here. Let's see. Who just joined us? Yeah, there's not much echo at all. How you doing? Just beating Leneth? I thought Leneth was facing that Crimson Moon guy just now. No, you're not. You're HD. Alright. How you doing? Don't make me call my real name. I know you hate that. So what do you know about this Mitch Guada guy? I've never heard his name before in my life. Watching an ad? Alright. Well, if you get on, there's a Blanca Ryu player featured with about 1,500 BP, 15,000 BP, with Blanca Ryu. I've never heard this guy in my life. What are these guys' combos? I can hear you just fine. How you doing? Excellent. I don't. I'm watching Cross Second right now, so I'll worry about that right now. This guy's Blanca combos are really jank. So is Ryu combos, actually. There we go. Homeless,
thank you, horse,
how you doing?
Alright, you know, just doing Lennox stuff.
Kimbo was muted again. That'd be funny if I did this second time. Alright, we are good to go now. Let me turn the volume down. There we go. Alright, there we go. So, I don't know anything about this Mitch Guada guy, but his combos aren't that great for a guy who has as much BP as he does. He seems to rely very heavily on his footsies and his links into Cross Rush. And then just get optimal stuff off
that. Before I joined Xbox Live.
Well, even so, 15,000 BP is a lot.
Yeah, but, you know, PSN.
Even so, Xbox was the main source for a long time. Allegedly.
I left this for Xbox Live.
Everyone said Xbox was like the main source for a long time and the quote-unquote preferred console, even though Sony was one foot in the bill.
Yeah, that was weird.
FGC is weird in general. Because most of them don't like this wonderful game. That being said, let's see what we got next on this little channel.
Yeah, this match sucked, honestly.
I was surprised that guy 15,000 BP with the gameplay he was doing. But he doesn't really offer that much challenge. Oh, look who it is!
Who?
You can't see it yet?
Horseplay?
No, it's you.
Oh yeah, it is me.
Alright, let's see what Brucey Boy's got.
Yeah, and I could tell y'all step-by-step what I'm doing, too.
So right now, he's using his frame advantage to pressure this Ogre.
Yeah, I'm pushing medium punch all day.
Lucky for him, Ogre isn't confirming his strings, or he'd be in serious trouble. See, right there, that's not safe. Don't do that in crushing opponents. Don't do it to Sampa that much either.
Lennox, I will recommend, do not look up Chun-Li and Ogre in DeviantArt, because you'll probably find something scary.
By the way, this is really Lenneth. This is a homeless dragon. So, hello.
Hello, Lenneth. You got me pub stomping with Lars. You need that medium kick.
Well, right now, Ogre managed to catch you with that waiting moon. Again, what? Don't do that. All right. So, if you're facing Chun-Li, a lot of the abusable strings won't really work that well just because she has that crouching leg kick. It reaches far in three frames. So, it's not a combination. Same reason why Bison boosts won't work at certain characters.
Yeah, but of course I knew that because I'm Lennox.
Right now you're very lucky that this Ogre isn't confirming those low strings.
Of course I'm using Lars on pub stomping. I was like, I got onto
so much
like,
frame advantage. So much frame advantage. So I should note. Chun-Li's best overhead, only overhead really, is that Hazanshu, that flying split kick. So if you're in that situation and you don't get any near to alpha counter, just know that more often times than not, he's going to go for a low than the Hazanshu, just because the Hazanshu is a lot more reactable than the lows. So down back, the worst happens you get thrown. And you can watch for that as well. But that's a lot of...
You can launch it if you know you're coming.
You can. But it's harder than it looks.
Holy shit, those points.
Cause you... Oh, wow, that's, someone's got gem stacked. That's a lot of points. You're absolutely right. Who is that? I missed the name. Super...
something like that.
I have no idea who this is. Let me see what he's got. In the meantime, all but one of the characters has the health gem on.
I don't know what those purple things are, and I'm glad if I should know.
They're the health gem. They give you like a few hundred. I think they give like 100 extra HP, something like that.
How do I sound, by the way?
You sound great. Not as good as me, though.
I'm using my blue microphone made by you.
That's right. Thank you for supporting my hardware.
You're welcome. Why do you use such a bad microphone if, you know, I could buy like a $80 one from you that's a whole lot better?
Because it's 80 bucks.
Yes.
Alright. Oh no, drop this combo. So, this Super Duke guy, Super Dukes, I guess I should say, he's not too bad. I like his block strings.
I don't know, because, you know, Jin should be going around all of Jack's garbage.
I'm talking about the 60,000 BP guy, not the Jin player.
Oh, yeah, true.
Yeah. Let's see what happens.
I would like to see this guy against Liquid.
I'm sure you would. So this is what Jack has to do. When Jin comes to dash in, you want to make sure you have a geyser either where he is or where he's coming to cover yourself.
Gotta have that mental alertness.
You want to make sure you can force the jump so you can give him the rocket uppercut. Oh, that could have been it. That was a big chance to turn around. Tags didn't cause it, at least.
If only one of those hits, it's a ridiculous amount of block or hits done.
This guy's catching all the rolls. Doing a good job keeping Kazuya out of his grill where bad thing can happen. All right, he got him there. Big damage. Play.
This could be at any time of Xbox Live, you know, PS or cross-Tekken existence. But this could be like 6 years old.
Oh, he got him! I didn't think you would catch him like that. That's kind of a long ways away. But Kazuya just lunged forward.
My hands smell like chlorine.
Why is that?
Because, you know, giving a bath to dogs, no ticks or stuff.
Oh no!
Because I'm Lenneth.
Well, you know, focus on this match right now. Because the Jin Kazuya might make a comeback. That looked really hopeless, but Super Juice gave it away.
And in case for all of you who don't know, Jack has more health than most characters.
Yes. He's a big character. Typically goes hand in hand unless you're in Marvel because people complained about Sentinel too much.
Sentinel shipping confirmed.
Sentinel had the highest health in Marvel up until a mid-patch in Ultimate. Then he had like Capcom girl health, even though it was giant, easily overheadable. It's really dumb.
So you're telling me that Ibuki and Sentinel could take the same amount of hits?
That's right.
That is weird.
I know, I hate it too.
So what could Kazuya do against Jack?
So you want to be using a lot of crouching light kicks. And obviously, same deal as Jin, you want to have a crouch dash unlock in case you can get past a geyser. But I think, that's a good answer here. I think Jack has a lot of ways to avoid getting hit by the crouch dash that other projectile characters don't, just because of the way projectiles work. I don't think you can crouch dash through a geyser when it's still active. I think at that point,
it's across Tekken community, Lenneth. I'm Lenneth, and I want Lenneth to join.
And this Super Dude took it pretty convincingly that round. I do like seeing the use of anti-air cross arcs.
What do you think about Akuma in this game?
I think he's not as good as Ryu. I don't care what Saber says. There's no way. And, I mean, put it this way. There's a reason why Ryu's the one who is labeled potential top five in Japan. Akuma isn't. Just saying. Meantime, we have a pair play battle.
A what?
Pair play. You know what pair play is, right?
No.
Oh my god.
Pair play?
We got a scramble battle. I said pair play.
I couldn't hear you that well, you know, because you have a crappy mic.
This mic works perfectly. Stop it.
Oh my god, why the hell are you showing this?
I don't know. Let's see what happens. So just a reminder, this mode exists.
Just like what we did, like, week 2 PSN.
Yes. And then it stops. Very unfortunate.
Who was it? I know there were some people. Oh, Maximilian played this game not too, like, a while ago. And instead of playing one, he was doing Scramble. I was like, are you serious?
Let's go another one.
Yeah, good. Like, you know, this is making me sad. And it's 5 round. That's all you need to know.
Let's try that again.
Why'd you look at character specific replays?
Because I tried that last night. All I got were like D ranks.
What about Xiaoyu? Because, you know, I tried Xiaoyu with PC and I kept getting DLC glitch for some reason.
If this one more time, I'm going to go to the character ones.
Yeah, Jailbait. We need that Xiaoyu.
You know what I might do, though? I might just go to the leaderboards and just pick out a replay from each person leaderboard.
Not again. Please, not again.
Let's see what happens. Yep, okay, never mind. We are going to the leaderboards, ladies and gentlemen.
I got so many videos to upload, it's not even goddamn funny.
Yes, it is, because you're Lena. And you're always funny.
Yeah, I know. I am very funny because I'm Lena.
You want to do this one time? I'll see what goes on here.
What are you talking about?
Quote unquote new replays.
Okay, why not? What's the worst that could happen?
I'm seeing who's on it. Who's this?
Oh my god, that first result is gonna trigger me so bad because I'm Lenneth.
Let's see what this guy's got.
I gotta tell that bitch ass homeless to get on.
Yeah, you go do that. Okie dokie, let's see what we got here. I like this team, Huarong Bob.
I won't hold back. Huarong and Bob?
Yes.
Is he like the love child of Cool Kid and Zombie Driver?
I've seen Huarong Bob before. That Drogo guy used him.
Oh yeah. He was cool.
I like Drogo.
I beat him.
Yeah, that's nice.
Because I'm Lenny. Obviously.
Obviously. Oh no, he missed the string. Doesn't make a difference, he's still safe. Ron doesn't worry about anything in this game, because he's top tier.
Yes, he is. He can do whatever he wants except beating Ibuki. You know, I'm not if I endorse this statement.
Yes. Okay, what's the mix-up? Going low. Yeah, think about Horror in the corner. He just quits no matter what you do. He's got a really good DP. He has a lot of good overhead to combo. He has really fast lows that reach very far as well. He's got a good throw game. Far with the corner, do whatever he wants. Devlin. Oh, what is he doing? Did that easy input gem allow him to do an electric? That's an interesting tech right there.
I have no idea what easy input gems do.
Me neither. I could buy one and see what they do one day.
Oh, look at you, Mr. Rich Evil Champ.
That's right.
Show us your microphone.
This is my microphone right here.
That's a bad mic.
Oh no, he had it! Hey, Hachi guy had to confirm he needed to turn things around.
But, you know, because I'm Leonard, I say that Bob could Pandora cancel all of his normals. Is that true?
I've heard something like that, and I've seen it before in the past. Ooh, that's a nice chase down. Make a count. Good confirm. He remembered his juggle points. Alright, careful, careful. Don't get DP'd. Like that. And now, caught him again. This is chance.
Why the hell are you voting for the Horang player?
I was talking about the Heihachi player.
It's like feeling bad for Brock Lesnar.
I was voting for Heihachi. I don't know what you're talking about. I was thinking Heihachi was mixed up really well, just said watch out for Huarong's DP. And eventually got caught, and that was the end of that. Oh, wow.
almost lost weight.
Damn, he just disappeared. Hold on. Sorry if you could hear stuff.
I can hear you just fine.
No, I mean, like, sorry if you could hear stuff in the background.
Who, me?
No, me.
Oh.
I'm sorry. Okay.
All I heard was your voice.
Oh, okay.
There we go.
Your sweet-ass voice.
That's right, my beautiful voice.
Your commentator voice.
That is absolutely right. I'm going to sound like this until I'm 80. I'm going to sound like I'm 12 years old forever. No matter how much muscle I gain or how hard I work out, all testosterone I gain in the meantime, I'm just going to sound like I'm 12. The Mike Tyson effect.
Mokuba.
Who?
I'm not saying around.
Mokuba? Are you talking about like Kaiba's brother?
Yes.
I don't sound scratchy enough. He sounds more manly than I do, to be honest.
Shut up, Mokuba.
No. Alright, let's...
That was a Yu-Gi-Oh! Bridge joke.
I haven't seen Yu-Gi-Oh! Bridge. I saw an episode of
Saints... Oh my god, I hate you. First La Lily La Lay, now this. I hate you now.
I like La Lily La Lay.
No.
Okay. Was this the faker? The fake cool kid?
No, what are you talking about?
This guy right here. I forgot about this guy. No, let's look at his team real quick. No, this isn't him. Hold on, let's go to,
You gotta look at Ryan Hunter. I know we're battling.
Well, I'm gonna go down the list and see what we got. So hold on just a moment.
Now that Gal Palkia guy was a clown.
Whoa! He was on recently, it seems.
I could beat him.
2 years ago, he was last on.
Hey, it's David.
Wait. No, I think God might have been the fake guy. The booster. He's playing...
Could have been.
Because he's playing, Cool Kid's team. Let's see what happens. Because I think Cool Kid had a monopoly on this Cody Bob team. And Cool Kid said, I found my impersonator. It was actually this... Or it might have been this guy. This might be the booster we heard about. It's been a while. This was like 4 or 5 years ago I heard about this guy.
Yeah, that was crazy. No, I'm Lenneth. David, I'm Lenneth, I swear.
Hold on a second.
Do you not read chat?
Oh, I'm not reading right now. Hey guys, how you guys doing?
You forgot to read? You know, like, I could send you some YouTube videos.
No, I want to see what this happens. Oh no, he dropped the combo. This is not Cool Kid. Cool Kid's much clearer than this.
I'm Lenneth, that's what I do, David.
Hello, Horseplay. Welcome to the show. Watch Cool Kid's impersonator beat this zero BP guy. This has to be the impersonator. He's way too sloppy to have this many BP on Xbox Live.
This battle's making me sad.
Yeah, like I said, this can't be a guy worthy of all that BP.
I'd rather look at scramble mode than this.
Well, he only has one reward. We're gonna go down the list and see what we got. Oh, that wasn't too bad. That was combo this time.
You mean he streams somewhere else? He's too good for us YouTubers. He's the Evo champ.
Excellent. Oh, that was nice. I like that, actually. The Zonk blowing up the EX Hadouken. Now you should be doing a point blank anyway, but hey, still looked nice.
Because I just came from giving my dog a bath and I'm Lennon.
Just a moment. I got it. Let's change the volume mixer. Oh, by the way, Daniel Bryan signed a new 2-year contract with WWE.
Yay.
That's... Open volume mixer. Keep doing that, by the way. I want to test it real quick. Keep doing it. All right.
Okay, hold on.
All right.
Yay.
Perfect.
Yay.
David, is that better? Can you hear him better? Let's watch the actual Cool Kid do his work now.
Damn. Have you ever played Rock Band Blue?
Yes.
Have you ever done singing on Painkiller?
I did singing on Man the Box.
No, Painkiller.
By Judas Priest?
Yeah.
I didn't do that song. I should have, though. There's a really good... There's a good Chinese cover of it. I'll show you later.
No, but I mean, like, you gotta go very long at the end. So, like, I was able to get it.
Stop. Enough. So Cool Kid's about to...
try it again if you want.
No, we're gonna watch Cool Kid play Lord Denok.
I'm doing it anyway.
No, I'll mute you if you do. We're talking about this match. Van Hammer!
I can't do it.
Okay, we're gonna watch this match.
Yes, I'm Lannis, and I also say Fat Princess is a good game.
You're gonna watch this match, I'm gonna kick you out, man.
Well, I'm talking to the chat.
I'm watching this match, we're commentating. In the meantime, stop talking, focus. So, I'm watching Cool Kids Cody right now.
I'm being harassed by your chat, and like, you don't be.
I'm gonna mute you, man. Sorry, man. Time out.
Hey, you make me sad.
Okay, back to what we were doing. Okay, let's return. Until, quote unquote, Lenneth gets his act together. Missed a lot of stuff here. So, I know that seems abusable, or like, something you blow up, but really, that's a good option for Boss, just because his jump arc is so low for neutral jumping, and as well, that jumping roundhouse hits twice, so it's going to mix people up in situations where they're going for an empty low, or even going for only one kick and then the low, or a throw, something like that. So right now, Cool Kid doing excellent pressure, going for a long combo and the reset with the overhead target combo. Which is not a true combo, but it mixed people up, like it did there, cause a reset. Cool Kid with the Kings, Lakers, Cody Bob, and Lord Denok with some odd colors for King. I guess King must be Ahmed Johnson. Good cross up by Cool Kid. Gonna go in. So the tornado gave him a long time to set up a Oki situation. That could have been it right there. Another raw launch, and that is the end of that. Good stuff, Cool Kid. It's really like, I think raw's like three or four times there. Very impressive. So, the way that team works is Cody has some amazing buttons that cover lots of situations. Great anti-airs, great ground normals, lots of good ways to approach while still attacking. His tornado allows him to set up Oak situation very easily because of the long hit stun. And of course, Bob, a lot of great buttons as well. He played really odd position, really. Let's see what Zombie Driver's got. This better not be a Bear Smash. That would suck. Go for it. Don't to expect, but big BP difference right there. Let's look back at the chat and see what's going on. Nice read by Daza, but not quite enough just yet. A rear drop by Zombie. That's a good conversion, though. Hard to convert off that. At least in an air-to-air situation. Or ground-to-air. Excellent anti-air. So I gotta switch it, because there's so many AAs this game, air-to-airs, anti-airs, I might just call it ground-to-air for the time being for things like that. Or AA or A2A. So I'm going to get mixed up on commentary very easily. That happens so often. Those guys feel each other out a bit. So much plus frames from Huarong. But Julia, no stranger to being advantage herself. We'll have excellent normals that can confirm to her specials and lead to combos, but not that one. Another drop by Zombie Driver. That's a match I've seen many times. Bison's main tools are going to be standing medium punch, standing medium kick, and crouching light. But Raw Slide didn't pan out at all, and now he's in big trouble. Thankfully, though, oh no, Jeff just used it. There we go. Best roast of the game. EX Tiger Crusher. Heard this name in a while. I think he's on Guilty Gear now, but that was like years ago I heard that, so I know what he's doing right now. Probably Guilty Gear. Oh, awesome. He's playing Christy. I'm gonna feature Christy a little bit later. I was actually gonna get AC Jammer to come on, but he said he couldn't find any replays. So that's unfortunate. We'll think of something later, though. For now, just keep watching. Poison Christy. Two very underutilized characters being used in tandem against a Ryu Ken player. Let's see what we got. I just feel like dancing. Now, the show's ready to begin.
He sure does. Oh yeah. You guys are going down. Let the madness begin.
Don't get hit by it. Oh, he got hit by it! Oh my goodness. Come on, Ryan. Really? What's going on here? Yeah, punish. Okay, there you go. He handed it to you, Ryan. Come on. Don't play with your food in ranked. Come on. You can still play clean against randoms. You don't have to be that way. I missed it again. This match makes me sad. There we go, good follow-up. Ryan, you're acting weird in this match. But those are pretty cool combos. Poison and Christy, both known for her very strong normals. So this is a pretty good match, but it's rare that I see Christy on point and Poison in the back. Usually it's going to be Poison in the front. She's like one of the purest point carriers of the game. Well, Christy can play in either position, so it's weird seeing Christy clear in the front while Poison in the back. But Christy making excellent use of her standing heavy punch, but still dropping all the follow-up combos. Getting a bit too fancy. He probably would have gone for the SmackDown for a ground bounce follow-up. Miss another follow-up and lets Ken have another chance at life. Is he trying to get in? Good anti-air. So when Christy's in handstand, that's probably your best anti-air in terms of like starting combos. Otherwise, she's going to use her crouching heavy punch a lot to keep people out as it retracts her hitbox a lot. Her hurtbox. Hitbox is the one that hurts people. Hurtbox is the one that people get hurt with. So, retracts her hurtbox, and so it basically becomes like one big hitbox. Davey, do you realize I'm Jewish, right? Stop talking about Hitler. Give me a break. You beat Aaron. Sure you did, Barris. Sure you did. Miguel, one fighter. No, I'm not playing that. This might be fun, though. Haven't heard this name in a long time. See what we got with this Raven Lars player. It's a pretty good team. Akuma Kaja's not that bad either.
Eliminate potential threats.
Very interesting indeed. So Akuma trying to establish a zoning game first up. Raven known for his zoning as well as a lot of very powerful combo starters. Raven has excellent damage on top of a variety of play styles. He can rush on people fairly well. A lot of his normals have a lot of good advantage and decent range. Of course, fireball gain is very strong. He can have a fireball going straight above someone's head rather than an arc like Akuma's air fireball. And Raven has more health than Akuma as well. A Raven with the CADCs on point is very scary as well. Big chance for Kaz to make something happen. He caught him in a counter hit overhead, which is a ground bounce, but wasn't enough to get a big combo. Thankfully, though, he still has a long lead. That's going to disappear quickly. Here comes Lars. Sneaky cross up EX silent entry. Good job blowing up the empty jump. Don't confirm. Alright, good. He confirmed. There was a mix-up there. I think both are unsafe. But if not, only the low is a true combo if it confirms. That was all block right there. Kylera doing a good job waiting his turn so he didn't get a reversal during that string. And managed to finish things up. Of course I'm right, it's Hitler! Why would it not be right? You can't be calling yourself that. He's meant to be taken seriously, especially today, where everybody's worried about, like, people getting persecuted. I mean, here in America, it's like Holocaust the sequel right now. Guys getting deported to minorities and stuff. It's scary. Don't laugh. I worked with a kid who was worried about that. The family was worried because they came from Salvador. And I stopped working with him like the week before the election. Then he won. I thought myself, I'm glad I didn't have that case anymore because I convinced him it wasn't going to happen. So I don't know anymore. It's scary. Stop picking on these low BP people. Come on. All right, Banana Ken. Him I know. Okay, this one might actually be pretty good. Banana Can versus Ryan Hunter, and Ryan playing the two characters he's best known for, Julius Steve. Yeah, Dave, it's really nuts over here. It's very scary in terms of like the way people are being treated around here. But hopefully, he'll lose all his Senate seats soon. Things get back to normal because this is kind of a harsh one we had to learn about keeping track of our politics. Otherwise, people like him get just voted in and then he gets full control of everything. Anyway, let's move forward with, so when I first saw this team, I thought this was Siam, aka SRKJKF, Jurikill's friend, because he plays the exact same team and got top 8 EVE with him too, but no, it's Banana Ken. There's another guy in my area called Ken, who plays Ken Huarong, very strong player, and I thought he was this guy when I first met him, because I was still new to, the fire new ones in the streamer community. But no, it's a different guy. He's having to all play the same characters. Man, can do an excellent job. Oh, that could have been good. Just a little bit too early. Hunter wasn't going for the full combo for Steve, which is the flicker cancels in the corner. But Ryan Hunter was one of the best Steves around for a long time, as well as one of the quintessential Julias. So I'm glad we have to see it in action today. All right. This is a battle between two no-footsie characters. Liz is going to look for either a dive kick or her special overhead to blow him up. Meanwhile, Steve managed to catch him with the neutral jump. With a big combo. Got a little bit greedy with the command throw. Only works on standing opponents. Good raw launch. Excellent raw launch by Banana Ken. I'm not saying because it worked either, because most people are very tempted to hit crouching light punches and crouching light, just because most people don't like standing moves that much, because a lot of times standing jabs will whiff over crouching characters, so the crouching jabs cover more space as a counter poke. So that was a good awareness by Banana Ken. Ooh, that's good. Very tight combo. And Ryan feels up a bit with the teabagging. There's another one. It's probably a dead Banana Ken. Maybe not, Magic Pixel. Oh, he's so lucky to get blown up worse than he could have. Ooh, that's a very meaty overhead. Didn't reset him that time. Lily trying to find her way in, but that dive kick. Don't do it against Julia. She has a really good DP to stop all that. Very nice. Julia on the ropes. Banana Ken trying to retreat. Okay, that's good because now Ryan has his lead back. Building meter, whiffing normals. They got enough meter to make things happen. Excellent blocking of the cross-up Tatsu. Lots of good blocks here, actually. He didn't get the link, but he knew Hunter was going to try and challenge anyway. Therefore, Banana Ken takes it convincingly. Through an excellent use of awareness and analysis of situations that were in front of them. I'm trying not to call it raids too much. Comparing people hate that term now, because whenever someone gets red in Street Fighter V, they say it rewards bad players just YOLOing. So I'm going to avoid that terminology for now. Apparently it's a banned word now. Valmaster. Haven't heard that name in a long time either. Street Fighter IV player, if I recall correctly. I'll play it just because he's playing Elena. Well, I said in closer matches, though. They gotta have a way where both sides have fairly close BP, so we don't see all these curb stompings, you know? Open the chat back up. Let's see who comes in. No. Come on. There we go. We just jumped in. Someone jumped in. Let's go back. Hey, Blue Six, how you doing? Tell me about Team YP, if you could, Mr. Blue Six. I don't remember YP that well. But I do remember Valmaster being a Street Fighter 4 player. So lately, I've been playing in Final Boss again, and getting reclaimed as Elena. Very strong character. Excellent pokes. That slide is an excellent setup to use those pokes as well, being it's a hard knockdown. Interesting. So apparently, YP stands for you porn. I didn't know they had that, unless it's just a kind of a joke. Good use of the EX scratch. The EX Mallet Fall. I can't remember the names of them. Scratch Wheel is the DP, and Mallet Fall is the overhead. Big combo. No follow up. Didn't make a difference, though. Right now, Elena has all the advantageous normals to make things happen. So she's under no pressure against that Kuba in the corner. It does sound like a joke, so... Yeah, I didn't know they had that. I guess I wasn't paying attention at the time. I was too worried about my career. Carmageddon. I think... Look at this team. I think this is what I'm thinking of. With a name like that, I don't blame them. I mean, you gotta be all age and stuff. So, yeah. Especially today, like I said, PR is a big issue today. You have to protect your brand and know that everybody's watching and everyone will judge you. Geef and Brian with Geef on point. All right, then. Let's see what we got. Karm under no pressure to worry about this 3,000 BP player, Sonic Pro Game. He's paying for it. He's getting some good combos in. What are you doing? Alright, he's trying to feel it out, maybe, or maybe he's gonna die. Is Karm? Okay. So, I'm gonna see what's going on here. Well, I'm sure someone did research and said that's what it was for. So, I don't know what they were expecting. Alright, so I think Karm was doing, he's kind of playing with him a bit. Which is kind of a jerk move. I hate when people do that. Someone did me in Samurai Showdown Tournament. Just sandbagged the first round, and then I got bopped the second and third round. I hate that. Come at me everything you have. I won't mind. Then don't have the name in the first place. I mean, if you're ashamed of who's sponsoring you, don't accept them. Simple as that. I don't know what Karma's thinking. Let this guy just tee off on him once. Because Geef Brian is not the kind of team that can just turn up like that. Brian Geef is a team that has to let the opponent get complacent. And you typically need the very first round to make that happen. You can't just be sandbagging like that. Because too many things can go wrong in case they know you're doing that and then they approach you. the right or wrong way. He's lucky Asuka is not punishing those blocked boost combos. Karm not being too complex here, just being defensive. Sadly, Asuka Ibuki is not adapting. I don't know why either. Asuka's ground game is pretty strong if he can get in range of Geef. Tag out? Okay, see what Buki's got. I'm fine with this because, like, Brian's like a modified android. So he might have, like, some enhancement to his physique like that. Yeah, this is basically like Yamazaki, pretty much. This Brian. Blue 6, so he was basically a guy who was shot a lot, so, and then he died, and then his body was donated to science and given all these mechanical enhancements, then brought back to life. Before then, he was basically a dirty cop. I'm trying to find some closer matches. Other than just two guys, just a guy just bopping someone else with no challenge because, like, a low-ranked guy. So it looks like this is around the time everyone started leaving because a lot of the other ranks were starting to disappear. I mean, this ain't been a while. Alright. I gotta see this. Jimbo versus Lemeth. Let's see what we got. Jimbo versus GG Nostalgic, aka Lemeth, aka Bruce. Let's see if Bruce lets me down in this match or not. Jimbo playing one of his backup teams, Blanca Hugo. He pulled this on me back in 2013 when I invited him to Richmond to play. I had a lot of work to do back then, but it was fun to face him. These days when I asked him to play cross tech, and he told me about better stuff to do. And when I asked to promote, he just told me it's not going to help if I promote or not, so... That's him, and that's okay. But I guess because it's me asking, it's not valid. Because I've heard Parapets and others say that when they ask him, he's sometimes down for it. That's unfortunate. Oh no, he caught him! Yeah, he caught him. He set up by himself. There was no Hugo tag set up that time. I'll have to watch that again and see what the setup was. And the replays. I kind of like only half like paying attention, looking at the chat talking. Hey, Parapets, how you doing? Yeah, Parapets, whenever I asked Automatic if he wants to play, he tells me I don't think it's going to help or whatnot, but I've heard others have more luck with him saying he'll play Tam or something like that. So, that's unfortunate, but it is what it is. Ooh, that was nice. Hugo went the wrong way, though. I don't know how you wound up over there. So that's interesting. Lemeth trying to establish some control. That's not how to do it, though. Lemeth, short on BP in his match. I'm assuming it's one of his earlier matches. He's starting to get acquainted with the fire nuance of this game. Good use of the standing medium kick to get the frame advantage you need to stop whatever counter poke Lev's going to use. Good stuff to Jimbo, aka Automatic. How you doing, Parapets? see what Mr. McDermott's got, aka Hero of Time. Yeah, let's not do that. I'm trying to avoid pair play matches and matches where just one guy stomping another person who has no BP at all. Yeah, Parapets, me too. I'm just trying to find closer matches because a lot of these things I'm finding on the leaderboard are just curb stompings of a guy with like a ton of BP versus someone with almost no BP that have no name I've heard of. I can't show good replays because the Elite channel is mostly the same, just one Elite guy stomping on a guy with no business being there. This might be good, though. Mecha Oni, a.k.a. Greg from my area, played this game a lot back in the day. Let's see what he's got playing Ken Sagat. I don't remember him being a Ken Sagat specialist, but hey, if it's here and he's facing a guy close to 15,000 BP, he should be good. Keep saying 100. It's got to be 1,000. Man, what a drag. Why can't they leave me alone? I guess I found the right suspect. If you don't take this seriously, you're going to get hurt. Every battle? That's Scarlet Screen. Very interesting. This team's very green, actually. Ken with the Black Panther lime green suit. Oh, wait. Yo, this is a version 1.0. This is vanilla. We're watching a vanilla match. I just noticed because the flash of the launcher was different. I'm looking at the version info right now. We're watching a vanilla match. And we're going to see just how ridiculous vanilla was. And by the change for 2013, we're mostly very good compared to what was before. Like, I love vanilla a lot, but 13 was much better after I learned how to understand what it's about. Good space raw launch. Look, it's already 47 seconds in, and almost nothing Lei and Cody are doing are hurting Sagat, even though Sagat having defense gems on. So I don't think it's one of those hybrid gems. Typically the hybrid ones where you had increased stat but lost another one. Tiger Knee on wake up. So much pushback on that move in this version. I should know, I was a Sagat main as well, just because all of his boosts had enormous pushback, which allowed him to get space to throw fireballs again. Didn't have Bridge 2013 anymore. He got nerfed super hard. He probably got nerfed harder than everyone else in the whole game, other than, like, maybe Hugo. Parapets, between, other than Sagat and Hugo, who got nerfed, like, super ultra mega hard in 2013 and got nothing in return for it? I know at least Ryu still had some cool stuff he could do, but Sagat had almost nothing, and Hugo got was damage, but everything else was all gone. Who would you say got nerfed the worst for 2013? Other than like DLC characters and certain gems. I know the crouching light kick nerf was very bad for him, but I don't know. I feel like he didn't get as little as those two got. Between the default characters, who got nerfed the hardest? I'd say either Sagat or Hugo, but I'm leaning more towards Sagat. Because Sagat was like all nerfable, nothing returned other than one move forcing standing didn't really help him that much. Alright. I'm going to show one more match after this, and I'm going to close up for the day, because I have to get back doing my laundry. So thanks, you guys, for showing up and watch Nostalgia. We'll try to do more stuff and have a bit more organized replays in the future. All attack gems blazing, it barely hurt. Got him. Goes for hard knockdown instead. Yeah, that move was like a target combo of how safe it was. Yeah, standing like it, the crouching medium punch, basically like a target combo. You just did it, and there was no worry about being punished at all. An Emblem Lord Sagat guy for this game, he even said it was like that. It was a just do it type move. All Spartan can do right now. It might not be enough. Yeah, Oni hung on. Maybe not. No, that was... He's still enough. Only one time over in vanilla. That's pretty impressive. I used to be like you back in 82. Is that a reference to something? I don't know. Guile definitely is up there for nurse didn't need to happen. Or at least nurse with nothing in return for it. Let's do one. Let's see if I find another name I recognize. Who did Ice play last? Yeah, sorry, I thought I'd show that. Okay, let's just start. Let's see what Japan's got. KGO's not Japanese, come on. Oh, look who it is, my buddy. I'm gonna close this out with a Punko match. That would be so perfect. As we near EVO 2018. Because this was Punko. Facing Punko definitely got me some eyeballs that weren't on me before I faced him in the lobby at EVO 2017. And as you might have seen on SRK, I was benched like a quote-unquote big name entering Marvel Infinite. And anyone can tell you, I am bad at that game. I mean, Lendith beat me. He hasn't played this game in months. So for me to just be included by virtue of my name is a huge honor, and I think that weekend was really where the turning point happened, where the brand that I've established with the help of this game really came into fruition. So thank you all for playing me this game over the years. You're all part of this journey I've been on, and it's been an honor playing this game and repping it for you guys. I look forward to doing it one more time at EVO 2018, as I'm not going to be present at next EVO in 2019. I have other stuff I might play. I'll be entering Combo Breaker and CEO instead run cross second there. Ooh, that was nice. I like that. Good job challenging it. So, the key to stopping that is using your best low attack. Unfortunately, not everyone has a low attack that'll beat it consistently, as a lot of times it'll hit them while it's still in startup frames. So having someone like Bison or a Chun-Li who has a low that comes out fairly quick and has a way to not stick the hurtbox out too much is a good way to counter the electric attacks. Otherwise, that's what you gotta face. Plus on block, insane damage on hits. Just keep doing it until they flinch. And if you catch you on block, try to throw a low afterward, because he's probably just gonna blow you up, because again, he is at advantage when he does that. So don't throw, don't use a crouching light punch unless that's a low. Just use your fastest actual low attack and make it happen. Max just asked me, I'm playing Xbox. Max, I need to get some stuff done tonight, but I appreciate the offer. We'll definitely play some more in the future. So thanks for the offer. In the meantime, I'm going to wrap this up. Everybody, I hope you enjoyed the trip down memory lane. There'll be a lot more to come in the future. Now I have the 360 up here in my room on my desk. It'll help me easier to stream and make this happen more consistently rather than go downstairs and set up my laptop, which is kind of a pain in the butt. So everyone, have a good day. I'm going to sign off and use the bathroom and get the rest of my evening squared away. So tomorrow I can get back to work and have a good presentation for my employers, showing them that we are on a good track. I'm doing my job as needed, so I can keep having the income to continue doing this for you guys and make this happen. I'm not asking for donations. I'm an adult, not a professional. This is all on me, but I do know I have work to do to make all this happen. So keep rooting for me, guys. Again, this is all on me, and I intend to keep doing this for you guys as a way to support the community. That's all I need. Support the community, not to get like a cash pay or anything like that, but support you guys and support people who still like this game. Show people there are still places to play this game, those looking for it. All right, have a good day, guys. Psycho Blue, thank you for crossing the line one more time. Until next time, where we cross lines once more. Let's close out. Just a moment. Hold on. All right. There we go. Once more. See you guys next time.